equally. A very warm welcome to Solway College and our very special Christmas Liturgy service tonight. As we mentioned before at our Christmas dinner, this is the most special event in our Solway calendar when we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we thank you all for being here today, students and staff, and for those joining us online for this very special evening, albeit that it looks a little bit different this year due to COVID-19. It is my privilege now to hand you over to some of our wonderful head students, as well as our beautiful chaplain, Mrs. Rees, who's going to lead us in our special service tonight. Thank you.
Christmas Liturgy 2021. I ask for you to please bow your heads as we open in prayer. Heavenly Father, we marvel that you should send your Son into the world. We marvel you, Lord Jesus, that you should be prepared to leave the glory of heaven to be born as a baby in a stable. Thank you for your awesome love. From our hearts may we echo the words of the angels, glory to God in the highest heaven. And first of all, I'm just going to ask you all to stand and sing. Once in Royal David City, and our choir will lead with the first verse, and then we'll join them second verse on this. Thank you. Please stand. Bring this.
This is how Jesus the Messiah was born. His mother, Mary, was engaged to be married to Joseph, but before the marriage took place, while she was still a virgin, she became pregnant through the power of the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her fiancé, was a good man and did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he decided to break the engagement quietly. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. "Joseph, son of David, the angel said, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All of this occurred to fulfill the Lord's message through his prophet. "Look, the virgin will conceive a child. She will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." When Joseph woke up, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded and took Mary as his wife.
Thank you, Fern. We'll now stand and sing together, "Away in a Manger."
Mama. second gospel reading is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 to 20. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread their word concerning what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Reminder that Christ is the light of the world. May his light be a constant guide to us all as we journey through life. I invite you all to please stand for our closing prayer and the singing of our final songs, "O Come All Ye Faithful, and Let There Be Peace." Please bow your heads for the closing prayer. Heavenly Father, may Christ be the centre of our Christmas.
May we all be guided by the light of Jesus. May we continue to discover more of your perfect, precious, everlasting, indescribable gift to us all. May our Lord bless you and keep you. May his love that surpasses all understanding be with us all now and forevermore. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Once again on IT. Thank you, Mr. Coffin. Mrs. Frank, once again, this year's been a really big year for Mrs. Frank because we've had to move to all our online services. She's done an incredible job filming to ensure that our families and friends at home can also still celebrate these occasions with us. To our lead students, thank you once again for your service tonight. And to all of our students for sharing your gifts and talent. You've all sung beautifully and you've all been fantastic. Last but certainly not least, we need to thank our amazing Mrs. Rees. Mrs. Rees, I just want to thank you for cherishing and seeing the best in every single one of our students and always being there whenever they need a supportive hand. Thank you also for your oversight and your leadership of tonight, but also all the way through the year, every day. You're such a blessing to Solway College, and you've certainly ensured tonight was an appropriately fitting occasion. So can we please acknowledge Mrs. Rees? Those not in the hostel tonight but heading home, wish you all safe travels. We look forward to seeing you back here 9:45 tomorrow morning for our annual school praise giving, dressed once again in your formal uniform. Me te atua e manaaki, God bless and good night. Thank you.